So if God exists, who is he? What's he like? And can he even help us? Some days, life is amazing. We get to enjoy great holidays, family and friends. But other days, we lose the very best parts of life. Our holidays, family and friends, well, it all can come to an end. And that feels especially true right now in the middle of a COVID-19 crisis. So how are we supposed to make sense of it? Some people think this is Mother Nature's way of healing the planet, of teaching us a lesson for all the damage we've caused. Korn guitarist James Schaefer had this to say on Twitter. Mother Nature comes to collect on the karmic debt. Hopefully, we all learn something about ourselves, culture, our interconnections on this planet. If Schaefer's right, we've got a bigger problem than COVID-19. We've got a planet that's against us. And if that's the case, we should be afraid. The planet's been around a lot longer than us. We're going to come off second best. So are we stuck in an endless cycle of death and rebirth? Are we stuck without hope? Thankfully, the Bible offers a completely different explanation. In the Gospel of John, we hear these words. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The good news is that God is the creator. He's made us and he's made the world, and we're both dependent on him. He's given us the earth to enjoy and to take care of. And God is the light of mankind. He's the key that enables us to live life to the full. But there is darkness in the world. Here the Bible doesn't hold any punches. Evil exists, and it's out in the world, and it's in us too. And our darkness has put us at odds with the light of life. As a result, we and the planet now live under the shadow of death. But wonderfully, John's Gospel offers us hope. You see, in John's Gospel, it tells us that the light of life has overcome the darkness. Because God's doing something to overcome evil, that means there's real hope for those of us walking in the shadow of death. Real hope in the face of fear. But you might be thinking, well, that sounds good, but where is this God? Click on our next video to find out.